Good morning, Hampton Academy Sharks. I'm Camden.
And I'm Alina. Today is Friday, May 28th, 2021.
This is a special Memorial Day Shark News.
We will start off this week's show with announcements, and then we'll be featuring a Memorial Day segment submitted by our Hampton Academy teams.
Attention 6th and 7th graders, we are currently working on next year's schedule. All students will automatically be enrolled in the same music class you took this past year on your remote learning days. If you would like to change your music course for next year, please see Mrs. Gay or Ms. Reno for a music selection form. All forms are due next Friday.
Attention all softball and baseball players. Now that the season is over, please remember to wash and return your uniforms to your coach. Congratulations on a great season.
Hi, Phoebe. I'm home, Gwen. Plus, W, good, pass, 7, all. Send butter and donation rents for a veggie amount.
Here's a reminder to all students who bike to school. You must wear a helmet. You may not ride your bike on school property if you're not wearing a helmet.
And now for your 5-day forecast. On Friday, it'll be 57 degrees with partly cloudy skies during the morning, which will give way to occasional showers in the afternoon. On Saturday, it'll be 53 degrees, windy with rain earlier in the day, and then remaining cloudy with showers in the afternoon. On Sunday, it'll be 56 degrees, overcast with rain showers throughout the day. On Monday, it'll be 64 degrees with rain showers in the morning, which will become more scattered in the afternoon. And on Tuesday, it'll be 72 degrees and mostly cloudy. That's your weather. I'm Alina.
Celebrating his birthday today is Jackie Wang. Celebrating tomorrow is Ryan Jameson. Happy birthday, Jackie and Ryan.
And now for your joke.
Hey, Addie.
Hey, what?
What kind of tree can you hold in your hand?
I don't know what.
A palm tree.
Our Memorial Day thought for the day comes from Harry S. Truman, who is the 33rd President of the United States, soaring from 1945 to 1953. Succeeding upon the death of Franklin D. Roosevelt after serving as the 34th Vice President, he said, "Our debt to the heroic men and valiant women of the service of our country can never be repaid. They have earned our undying gratitude. America will never forget their sacrifices." Harry S. Truman.
Our Memorial Day fact reflects on a famous speech given by Abraham Lincoln on November 19, 1863. President Lincoln delivered remarks, which later became known as the Gettysburg Address, at the official dedication ceremony for the National Cemetery of Gettysburg in Pennsylvania, on the site of one of the bloodiest and most decisive battles of the Civil War. Though he was not the featured orator that day, Lincoln's brief address would be remembered as one of the most important speeches in American history. In it, he invoked the principles of human equality contained in the Declaration of Independence and connected the sacrifices of the Civil War with the desire for a new birth of freedom, as well as the all-important preservation of the Union created in 1776 and its ideal of self-government.
Fourscore and 7 years ago,
our fathers brought forth on this continent a new nation,
conceived of liberty and dedicated to the proposition that all men are created equal.
Now we are engaged in a great civil war, testing whether that nation or any other nation so conceived and so dedicated can long endure.
We are met on a great battlefield of that war. we have come to dedicate a portion of that field as a final resting place for those who here gave their lives that that nation might live.
It is altogether fitting and proper that we should do this. The brave men living and dead who struggle here have consecrated it far above our poor power to add or detract.
The world will little note nor long remember what we say here, but it can never forget what they did here.
It is for us, the living, rather, to be dedicated here to the unfinished work which they who fought here have thus far so nobly advanced.
It is rather for us to be here dedicated to the great task remaining before us.
That from these honored dead we take increased devotion to that cause for which they gave the last full measure of devotion.
That we here highly resolve that these dead shall not have died in vain.
That this nation under God shall have a new birth of freedom.
And that government of the people, by the people, for the people, shall not perish from this earth.
My dad was in the Air Force and my neighbor was in the Army, so it's a way for me to honor their sacrifice.
It's to remember our loved ones and to just take a day to think about what our life would be like without them.
It's to honor veterans that have died.
The true meaning of Memorial Day is to honor the ones who have fallen. They have fought for us day and night and we don't even notice it.
It's to remember the soldiers who died in war.
It's a day of honor and to remember those who died fighting for America.
It's a day to remember the courageous men and women from all nationalities that have sacrificed their lives for the protection of this country and our lives.
It's to celebrate the men and women who gave their lives to keep our country safe.
We honor the fallen soldiers and visit my grandfather's grave.
The true meaning of Memorial Day is to make sure we don't forget the lives and purposes of those who died serving. People can easily get distracted with everyday life, so it's important to take at least one day to keep your loved ones in your heart.
It's about remembering the ones we've lost and honoring their sacrifice.
The meaning of Memorial Day is not only to honor their fallen soldiers, but also for their families. It gives them a day to remember loved ones and their sacrifices for this country.
Remembrance. Respect.
Honor.
Sacrifice.
Valor.
And that is the true meaning of Memorial Day.
The Marine Memorial, also known as the Lady of the Sea, was created as a grave marker for Captain William D. Downs, who was buried at sea May 25, 1945.
The stone monument was sculpted by Vincenzo Andrani and dedicated to Memorial Day, May 30, 1957.
The monument was commissioned as a grave marker and later became a special memorial monument to honor those who died and risked their lives for us at sea and in war times.
Mariners' families could not always visit a gravesite to plant flowers and share their memories.
Their loved ones are often buried at sea, and so this memorial gives them a special comfort and a proud place to reflect and remember their fallen loved ones.
Thank you.
The Flag of the United States, a Memorial Day presentation. On this Memorial Day, Team 7 Hampton would like to take some time to explain the significance of our nation's flag as a symbol of our country and as it is used in times of ceremony. The United States holds the service of those who protect our country in very high regard. One of the most symbolic ways we show our appreciation is by incorporating the American flag into the traditions and rituals of military and police funerals. The distinctive stars and stripes are a symbol of patriotism, bravery, and history. Such a powerful symbol comes with its own unique traditions and funeral etiquette. Not only does each star stand for a state and each stripe stand for one of the 13 original colonies, but the colors are also symbolic. Red symbolizes hardiness and valor. White stands for purity and innocence, and blue represents vigilance, perseverance, and justice. As Flag Day approaches, learn more about the history behind some of America's funeral traditions featuring flags. When the American flag is used during a ceremony for a service member, there are several rules to honor and respect the deceased. A flag should not be lowered into a grave or touched the ground. A flag should never be used as a covering for a statue or monument. A flag should never be used in such a way that will allow it to be torn, dirtied, or damaged. A flag should not have anything placed on it, attached to it, or marked on it. A flag should never be used to hold or carry anything. Any flag that is worn, torn, or dirtied should no longer be publicly displayed, but privately destroyed. In our town, you can drop them into the box on the front steps of our Legion Post 35 or at the fire station.
The origin of taps, the distinctive bugle melody played at U.S. military funerals and at memorials as a lights-out signal to soldiers at night, dates back to the American Civil War. In July 1862, U.S. General Daniel Butterfield and his brigade were camped at Harrison's Landing, Virginia, recuperating after the 7 days' battle near Richmond, dissatisfied with the standard bugle call employed by the Army to indicate troops it was time to go to sleep, and thinking the call should sound more melodious, Butterfield reworked an existing bugle call to use the signal at the end of the day. After his brigade bugler, Private Oliver Wilcox Norton, played it for the men, buglers from other units became interested in the 24-note tune, and it quickly spread throughout the army. It even caught on with the Confederates. Not long after Butterfield created taps, it was played for the first military funeral for a Union cannoneer killed in action. As a name for taps, the most likely explanation is that it comes from the fact that prior to Butterfield's bugle call, the lights-out call was followed by three drum beats dubbed drum taps, as well as the taps, and then simply taps.
And remember, before you speak,
text,
chat,
or post,
ask yourself,
is it kind?
Is it true?
And is it necessary?
And remember the Academy way.
Manage yourself.
Act responsibly.
And respect yourself and others.
Go out there and make it a great day.